Last 2 years, I wrote a book with my wife called Inspirasi di Negeri Kuala. So it is just like a compilations or let's say a memory of mine when I study in Australia. And then a lot of things I compile, what I found, what I met, what I observed, and what I experienced in Australia. So a lot of things I put become one topic, and then here's the book. Maybe someday you can borrow the book, and yeah, I can lend you the book if you want. Well, let's talk a little bit about education system in Australia, which is very, yeah, pretty much same I think with Indonesia, with British and USA. Well, let's start from primary school or preschool as well, kindy or kindergartens, and then secondary educations here, and then a lot of people go to university, you know, and then yeah, there are three choices. They can go to vocational education and training, like to get diploma or certificate or certified, let's say diploma, if you want to go to job yearly. So better for you to enroll in vocational education and training college. And then you can also go to private educations and training. This is also to get a diploma as well. And then, or you better go to like regular entry, which is university. So starting from diploma, if you want to just take diploma or directly the bachelor degree or graduate diploma. So before having a master degree, there is a transitions between bachelor and master. So graduate diploma, you can take this that degree as well, or directly to master degree for about 2 years and PhD for about three. Oh, sorry, three, four, or 4 years. Normally 4 years. And then this is the statistic of number of schools in Australia. So about 9,400 something, and then registered training and organizations and a lot of colleagues, you know. And then universities, about 43 universities, which has I think the same standard in a national international standard. So I would like to say almost all universities in Australia have the same quality, I think. Yeah, but they have, you know, some strength, I mean, in particular, let's say major, but another university may have different strength as well in different major. So every single university has the same standard, and then they base on, you know, international standard as well. So all of them are very qualified and very reputable university. And then this is the salary of teachers in Australia, especially secondary school teachers. I take the survey, I mean, I take the sample from secondary school teachers, and then you can look at the normal rate or average rate of salary in Australia for teachers. So for those who have less than 2 years experience, so on average, maybe you would like to gain about 40 41,000 something for year. So yeah, if we think $1 Australia is 10,000 rupiah, so it's about 400 million for years, or about 400 things million for years. And then for those who have 2 to 5 years experience, so you're gonna, you know, get like almost 600 million, I think, for year. So half billion, and then so on and so forth, until if you have, let's say, more than 20 years teaching experience, so normally you will get about almost 1 billion for a year. So the salary is very competitive. And I'm going to talk a little bit about the international students in Australia. As you know, Australia is the third largest number of international students. UK is the most, and then USA is the second favorite destination for study for international students, and Australia is the third one. Maybe third or fourth one, with French and Australia. So I think the third one, largest international students number. So you can look at the statistic 2018, it almost reached about 900,000 people or international students. And then even the most updated one, I think this is 2018 as well, 2019. So about 600,000 something international students enrollment in Australia for March in 2019. I think it becomes, you know, increasing and increase. I don't know exactly the impact of COVID and then COVID-19 in here in this year, but maybe the enrollments in Australia will decrease because it was affected by the COVID-19, I think. Yeah, you can look at the country as well. China, you know, international students from China is the majority, about 70 something percents of international students number in Australia. And then India also, they also send a lot of international students. Nepal and then Vietnam, I think, and Malaysia. I think Indonesia is after Malaysia. So a lot of Malaysian people in as Malaysians in Australia, Vietnamese as well, and Indian. Yeah, they just, you know, not only study, but also they work. A lot of Indian work in Australia. Well, these are eight universities recommended as your destination for study. So there is a consortium called a group of eight members. So the eight universities are considered as the best universities in Australia. The first one is Melbourne University. The second one is a University of Sydney. The third one, I think, Australian National University. And then University of Queensland, I think. And then University New South Wales, Monash University, Western Australia. And University of Adelaide, I think, as the in number eight, I think, University of Adelaide. So you can choose one of the eight, you know, universities in Australia. They are really fantastic. So this university are really competitive and really reputable. Very recommended for you. If you would like to go for, let's say, learning TESOL, for example, so Monash University can be one of the best choice, or you can go to Queensland University. But those who are interested in linguistic things, applied linguistics, I think Melbourne University and University of Sydney is one of the recommendations. But those who are going to go to, let's say, educations, mixing between educations and TESOL, University of Adelaide, my previous university, is also one of the best recommendation for you. Or there are some other university for TESOL or applied linguistic. If you are interested to study and continue study to Australia, I think here we go. Some other universities in Australia, which is, you know, very fantastic. Macquarie University is located in Sydney. University of Wollongong, yes, it's also in New South Wales. Flinders, it is in South Australia. Newcastle University, that's also part of a around area, Sydney, a city. And then Victoria University, that's close to Melbourne. I think it's still same state, which is Victoria State. So, and there are a lot of other universities as well. So you can browse and search which one is the best for you. But here are my recommendations. Yep. Now I'm going to ask you, please mentions which university belongs to this number. So you can go to Google and name this university. You can look at the picture, number one, number two, number three, number four. So 5, 6, 7, and 8. So I said to you just now there are eight universities, top eight universities in Australia. It's called a group of eight university. And now please search the university and put them in the number. Which number goes to which university? Get my point? Yes. You can post it in Google Classroom. Yep, and then here is the recommendation for scholarship. I think that's very familiar. Australia Award Indonesia or Australia Award Scholarship. It's open once a year, normally in February or March. So be ready with this with 500 triple ITP or IELTS 5. So you are eligible to register. And then don't forget, after you get the scholarship, the university will require a 6.5 IELTS band score. So make sure you are also studying IELTS, but don't worry, you just go step by step, like preparing your TOEFL first, 500, and then after you get the scholarship, you will have a training. So in that training, you need to achieve 6.5. And the stipend, so allowance, the money that you will get, about 205,000, sorry, 2,500 Australian dollar. So it's about 25 million per month. That's big money. So you can save a lot of money from here. Yep. Why study in Australia? A lot of people ask me, why you go to Australia? We don't go to UK, USA, and other part of the world. But I'm going to say there are a lot of reasons apart from these reasons why we should study in Australia. Yes, that's growing destinations. I said to you that's this the third one, the third biggest number of international students. So the third most favorite country for study. And then the global recognitions, yes, there's also very competitive international standard. And then yeah, all of them belongs to let's say world-class university. Cost of living is quite not that much. I mean, not expensive, especially in South Australia, Queensland. They are not really expensive, but big cities in Melbourne or Sydney or Canberra, yeah, that's much, let's say, more expensive compared to South Australia, Western Australia, or Queensland. Diversity of educations, yeah, since a lot of people come to there, and then many students from India, from Malaysia, from UK as well, from Middle East come to study to Australia, and then we mingle. We meet in the class, and then we discuss, we collaborate in our teaching and learning process, and then that's make Australia diverse. Technology based, yes, I think the teaching generate technology a lot. We have to learn about the how to use let's say many software in analyzing qualitative data, quantitative data, and then everything is based on the website. Emailing is also very common, and then a lot of technology things that we want to learn in Australia. Yes, English is native country. I think we can learn directly from Australian people and work. This is very fantastic. Yeah, there is a lot of opportunities to work in Australia. And this is one thing, I think we mentioned it last 2 weeks, so I don't want to repeat again. We talk a lot about Aboriginal people and Torres Strait Islander as well, and then the relation with Australian people or government.